Yeah.
Just press the
pause.
So today I'm going to be talking to you guys and teaching you college students a little bit about marine pollution. But first, I'm going to get into why I got into marine pollution. So it all started when I was 7 years old, and it was just a typical day at SeaWorld. When all of a sudden, my brother gave me the blankest face ever, kind of like this. And so when I said, "What's wrong?" he said, "Turn around." And like the picture behind me, I was face to face with one of the biggest killer whales I've ever seen in an observation tank. An observation tank is actually a holding tank where they hold the whales. And I actually had a very cool interaction with it. I put my hand up to the wall, it came up, and it actually followed me as I walked to the wall. So this made me want to go into marine biology and study more about the animals and how to help them, which involves pollution. So I'm going to be going over my main points, which are what are some things that cause pollution, why do we pollute, and the effects of pollution. My credibility for this is I've actually volunteered at 3 different places. I volunteered at the Santa Monica Aquarium, I volunteered at the Aquarium of the Pacific in Long Beach, and I also volunteered at the Aquarium, or at the Ocean Institute in Dana Point, California. I've been places. So now I'm going to get straight into the first topic, which is some of the things that we pollute. So the 3 most important things that actually pollute our ocean, which I actually have examples of, are yolks, plastic bottles, and plastic bags. Now, most of you are probably wondering, what's a yolk? Well, this is the yolk, and as it's appeared up here. Now, this is actually one of the most deadliest pollutions out there that we can throw away or throw into the ocean, because this will actually get caught onto a smaller animal, cause them to suffocate, and also with the bigger animals, it can get caught, such as in a dolphin, it can get caught on the nose and ends up scarring them, and they actually end up starving. Another thing is the plastic bag. As you can see from up there from the turtle, the turtle's favorite thing to eat is jellyfish. When this bag is floating in the water, it looks exactly like a jellyfish, so the turtle will actually come in and try to eat it. And the last thing and most important thing is plastic bottles. 75, an article stated by Earth Kids, which was published on December 18, 2014, states that 75% of all of our plastic waste ends up going to the ocean. And so this is actually really big numbers. Some of you guys might not think so, but if you take 3/4 away from $1, it's pretty big. So it can really harm us. So now that I've talked about a couple of things that actually pollute, the ocean, I'll talk about why we do it. So the main reason why we pollute is because we don't think about it. Raise your hand if you have ever thought about throwing something away and what happens to it after you throw it away. Not that many people. Right, so what ends up happening is we just don't think about it. We don't care where it goes, what happens to it, and we don't think. And then the second reason is we just don't care. Once it's thrown away, out of my hands, gone for good, I'm not ever gonna see it again. Well, the thing is, you actually do end up seeing it again. You see trash all over the ocean, you see trash all over you see trash all over the streets, you see trash everywhere. The Aquarium of the Pacific stated on an article that they published on the aquariumpacific.com on the 25th of December 2015 that 25% of people just throw something away just for the heck of it because they don't really care. And this is actually a huge number for people. We have enough trash to spread around the earth 3 times, and that's just from this year alone. That's a lot of trash, and 25% of that goes into the ocean. That's a lot. And it actually can harm and disrupt a lot of the animals that swim and everything, because it not only pollutes, but it dilutes. It actually causes the water to create cancer for the fish and everything like that. So the next thing I'm going to be talking to you guys about is the effects of pollution. Now, this is probably one of the easiest questions that I can ask. Who can tell me the number one effect on pollution that has on marine life? Okay. It's death. Death is the number one thing. Death is the number one cause of pollution to marine animals. 25% of all marine deaths, and this was stated again by the Aquarium Pacific on the same article, is 25% of the deaths are marine related by pollution. Pollution ends up causing a lot of marine deaths. And so it just keeps going. And what happens and why these deaths occur is because, like I said, we don't take care of the ocean. We don't take the process, the actual processes to do it. As I said before, it's trash. Not many of you guys know what happens with trash. So what ends up happening is when you throw something away, it not only goes into the dump, but what happens is they actually have a big burner that burns down all the trash. But plastic doesn't burn down. So what happens is the bottle becomes flat, ends up being pushed off into the ocean for animals to end up, unfortunately, disguising food and eating, or end up getting caught in it. So the last thing I want to do is to sum it all up for you guys. So the main thing that ends up happening is pollution. Pollution ends up causing not just effects to the ocean life, but also effects to our life. It ends up depleting the ozone layer, which is the layer that protects us from the sun, which is why our climate is getting, which is why our climate is raising, and which is why we're having global warming. Some people think global warming is a hoax. I actually think it's very, very true, because we end up causing our own global warming. So I've stated why, some of the things that cause pollution, why we do pollute, and the effects of pollution. So what I want to leave you guys with is that when you throw something away, think about what you do, what you're throwing away, and how you're going to throw away before you do it. Recycling is very important and can help not only help the animals, but help yourselves as well. Thank you. That's it.